Hi, I'm Stuart J. Perlman, and I want to welcome you to Stuart J.'s Lens, the Tales of Small Business in McKinney. I hope you enjoy today's tale. It comes straight from Small Business in McKinney.
Went to OSU, go Pokes, and moved down here about 7 years ago after my daughter was born because my sister was here. And she was expecting a child and we wanted to raise our babies together. And then about a year later, I moved to Kuwait and moved 9,000 miles away from my sister and her babies. I was a single mom at the time and was making decent money, you know, in my chosen career path, but just felt like there was something else out there. So I put my resume on CareerBuilder and got a phone call the next day from a recruiter, and he says, "I have this job, it reads like your resume, the pay is this." Yes was almost out of my mouth, and he said, "And it's in Kuwait." I said, "Oh, well, let me go do some research and figure out if Kuwait is a place I want to take my two-year-old." And so I did. I joined some boards and talked to some people who lived there. And a month later, we were on a plane. Planes go both ways. If I'd gotten there and hated it, I could always come home. My career was in government contracting, so contract management. So what it boils down to is arguing with people all day. We call it negotiation, but it's really just arguing. I was diagnosed with skin cancer when I was 26, so I began to take a really strong interest in my skin and what I was putting. After I'd been using it for a while, I thought, this might be kind of fun to do. I mean, I thought learning to knit would be really fun. Turned out it wasn't. It sucked. I mean, I like to try new things, learned how to make bread, I know how to, you know, learned how to make wine at one point. So I thought I'd try making soap, and I figured it would probably end like knitting did for me. But I made my first batch of soap and I was hooked. You know, I told my husband, "If you know me, you think it's absolutely insane that I spend my days over a soap pot," because I was very much the career girl who's gonna, you know, climb the corporate ladder, wear her power suits, and I just love this. You're gonna come to me because my soap makes your skin feel better, because my lotion makes your skin all smooth. So it's, I don't know, it's about helping people and making people's lives better, as opposed to, you know, getting people out of messes and cleaning up. We left Kuwait and thought we might want to try out Egypt for a while. And then the revolution started. We decided that maybe it was time to head back to the States. So I went for almost a year without making soap, and I was just twitching inside.
You felt dirty, didn't you?
Yeah. I'd use other people's soap, and that's no good. And we closed on this house in October, or end of September, and I immediately started making soap. Officially launched Lotus here in the U.S. in on December 3rd. I've always loved the idea of working for myself and, you know, being able to really provide direction for whatever I'm doing.
Great.
And getting to choose who I work with. And what you're left with if you're using a bar of commercial soap is basically a synthetic detergent. And so you're cleaning your skin with something similar to what you wash your clothes with, which is why it leaves your skin sometimes feeling tight and itchy and dry. The difference between that and handmade soap is that it retains all of its natural glycerin. So everything that's created in the soap making process stays in here. Also, it's the oils that the soap is made of. So if you select oils that have good skin loving properties, those properties come out in your final bar. Each oil has different properties that it lends to your final bar, and so I spent a long time researching the right combination of oils to give it good cleansing properties, to make it moisturizing and good lather, so that you don't, you know, so that you actually have bubbles and you feel like you're getting clean when you use it. Also, instead of using water, I use coconut milk, which gives it even more moisture and more of a creamy lather and just more of that good stuff that your skin is probably craving. There are people who make soap by using pre-made bases and then coloring and scenting it. I don't do that. Everything I make is a recipe that I have tested, developed, and used myself. I don't sell anything that I don't use. I don't sell anything that I wouldn't put on my child.
Did you use your own soap this morning?
I did, of course.
What soap did you use?
I actually am testing my baby soap.
You're testing your baby soap?
Yeah, I have a baby line that I'm launching in a couple of months, and so I'm testing on myself, and it's wonderful. I love it.
And are you baby soft?
I am.
No rashes?
No. No.
Are you wearing diapers also?
I am not. Not anymore. Or maybe not yet, however you want to think about that.
If you think you have a story to tell, send me an email. But I have to tell you up front, it better be good.